Praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Kelvin, and it's a joy to be with you again. That we're doing the series of brokenness, and I want to encourage us that this is the last episode, but God will still reveal even more. In Psalm 51, verse 14 to 17, the Bible says that, "Deliver me from the guilt of bloodshed, O God, the God of my salvation." And in verse 15, he continued to say, "Open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth of your praise." And verse 16, the prayer of this broken man, he said that, "For you do not desire sacrifice, or else I will give it. You do not delight in burnt offering." In verse 17, he continued to say that, "A broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, these, O God, you will not despise." My topic to you this week is about the contrite heart. You see, the word contrite means to be remorseful or sorry. Allow me to emphasize, it is not the deed that was killing David, it was the guilt that followed that was killing David. In verse 14, he said, "Deliver me from this guilt of bloodshed." You see, when we mess up, what follows immediately is guilt. But may God turn your guilt into glory in Jesus' name. David knew, "In as much as I have sinned, redemption already was provided." And so this week, point number one, it is that God does not delight in religiosity. He delights in relationship. David pushed himself with all his heart that he may be remorseful before God. So his heart convicted him to be remorseful. His heart convicted him to be sorry. And let me tell you one thing about God. God will never turn his back away from you. As long as you're contrite, he will never turn his back away from you. Praise the Lord. And so God does not delight in religiosity, but he delights in relationship. Bwana asifiwe. And so number two, it is that the ultimate sacrifice was already provided for. In verse 16, he says, for you do not delight in sacrifices. You see, in the Old Testament, for you to serve God, you had to offer an offering. You had to offer a sacrifice before God. But David here, he said, "For you do not delight in sacrifices." Let me bring it to our context today. It is not the amount of prayer you pray. It is the amount of faith that you have in the prayer you pray. And so here, David pushed himself to the point he said, "You do not delight in sacrifices," for he knew the ultimate sacrifice has already been paid for. Now today, brethren, the sacrifice was paid on the cross of Calvary. And so when Jesus was nailed on the cross and he said, "It is finished," let me tell you, allow me to tell you this. When he said, "It is finished," it means this: your guilt was finished. Your stress was finished. Your depression was finished. And in verse 17, he said, "This is what God desires, a broken spirit and a contrite heart." Two things about the heart. The heart has to be broken, and the heart has to be contrite. So it is not what you offer, it is who you are that you offer yourselves. Paul says this in Romans chapter 12, verse 1, that we are a living sacrifice. So you see, in the Old Testament, for sacrifice to be provided, it had to be dead. But now, because there's somebody who lives in us, who is Christ, we have been made to become living, not dead. And so let your heart be contrite this season. It has always been about brokenness. You see, God is always near to them that are broken. How I pray that in this season, you will continue to be broken before God. Because God is after brokenness. He's not after recklessness. He's after brokenness. And so this time, I am encouraging you. I've been in this season in Psalm 51. It has been a prayer, and it will continue to be a prayer, that God will always be near to them that are broken. May you be broken before God. Every time when you pray, may you be broken. Whatever you're seeking God for, may you be broken. Because it is not about us, it's about Him. Let your desires be in line with His will. In as much as you are asking God, "I want," question is, what does God want for you? So let your heart be broken. Let your heart be contrite. Allow me to pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I just want to thank you for the contrite heart that you gave us through your Son, Jesus Christ, that we can be able to profess and confess that we need a Savior in our lives. And therefore, God, may you take charge. May you take your place even in this time. We do know that, God, you will do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever ask or even imagine, according to the power of Christ that works in us. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Until next time, my people, God bless you.